These look like sheets of paper, but they fall apart in the water. And this is what we add to the beater.
Oh.
This is future pulp. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I've got our Hollander beater here. This will hold about 7 pounds of fiber. If you can come around, that there are blades inside of here. Okay, so I have with me 7 pounds of dry fiber, which I am just going to quickly soak in the water just because it makes it easier to break down when I add it to the beater. And I'm also going to go through a period of tearing this down by hand first. The worst thing about loading a beater is that you do not want to clog the beater. And that happens when you have either too little water and or too much pulp all at once. Number one, I am spraying off my mold. I'm cleaning off any of the old grit that's left over from past sheets. That will show up in my new sheet of paper unless I wash that off. And number two, you always need to soak your decal in your mold anyway for even fiber dispersion. Okay, so now I am ready to do the more traditional form of forming a sheet, which is vat pulling. So I have here a very large vat. This has actually been set up for making larger sheets of paper that require two people that hold the mold, but it works for a smaller one as well. So just like with the deckel box, I'm going to hog the vat first. You can see all my pulp is settled to the bottom since this has been sitting overnight. So I'm going to go in there. Pretty evenly dispersed. This is actually a cotton pulp that's been lightly pigmented. Creative techniques come in for a lot of the paper projects that I tend to work on with artists. However, with traditional paper making, this is the beginning of what I'm going to refer to as a post, which is simply a stack of couched sheets of paper. So first off, I've got my big board, then I have a felt. Felts are really great for wicking away water, and just an updated version of a felt is this material, which I'm referring to as Pellon. That's actually a brand name for this material, which is a synthetic interfacing used in sewing. This is the material that's sewed into your collars and your sleeves to stiffen them up. So what I'm going to do is actually, I've sprayed this all so it's soaking wet. I'm smoothing out my surface and getting all that excess water out. This can be a difficult thing for beginners. So I'm eyeballing the edge and I'm measuring with my fingers. And as you cooch, the higher you go, the easier it gets, just because you have a softer cushioning underneath all your sheets. And the cooch. I have a couple of air bubbles in there, but that's not going to bother anybody. You can also see the watermarks present, just because this is an old vintage mold. Okay, so here I've got some examples of what's called pulp paint. This is, for pulp paint, you need any kind of fiber that's really short. In this case, we have linen. As I explained before, linen not only is able to be beaten to a very short length, as it is here. This has been beaten for about 8 hours. It's pretty fine stuff, but it also takes color really, really well. So this orange is going to dry the same shade. Whereas with cotton, this sheet of paper, which is made of cotton, this base sheet that I've just made and cooched, will dry about 3 shades lighter than it is now. So a very, very off-white.
So this is the pulp straight out of the beater, just with pigment added to it. It's not really at pulp paint consistency that I want. So what I'm going to do is mix a little bit in there, and a little pulp goes a long way for pulp painting. So I'm just going to thin it out with water till I get the right consistency. You can also add various agents to smooth it out. I'll thin it here. Pretty good pourability. It's still a little chunky, but I'm happy with that. And so this, the simplest way to pulp paint is throwing that on there. So that's method number one. Number two, I just have these three bottles. Also, you can see that says black linen. These are all linen pulp paints, which I'm going to mix up. And shiny, it's just kind of sitting on top. It hasn't quite soaked in yet. I can sort of play around with that. This is called the Foggin nozzle. So with my Foggin nozzle, I can get different, really different techniques and different forms. This has that airbrushed spray paint look to it. And so here, you know, this is where, just through play, we've actually, a lot of paper makers have discovered new forms of creative expression with paper making. So this is the simplest one for me.